to worship the Lord in spirit and in truth. We are so grateful. We heard messages of the songs, and you know, the children, that the Lord Jesus Christ was born. It was a good news that He came on earth to save us. And also Brother Jeremiah saying about the faithfulness of God. Truly, we need to, God is immutable. He is faithful. That's why we need to be serious in what we are doing for the Lord. So because our God is faithful, even though sometimes we feel that we are so tired, we don't want to come to the church to gather together, but we need to change that mindset, because our God is really faithful, that He is always there for us. He take good care of us. And also the special number, Brother Hilson, and happy anniversary, Brad. I remember when I attended your wedding anniversary. Wedding day. I remember that time. Hindi mo ako inasikaso. He never mind me, but it's okay, no problem. At least I witnessed your celebration. Okay, so let's all stand up as we will not read anymore the verse that we have read, because we already read this. We just pray. Let's pray. Our Father in heaven, Lord, thank you so much for this day. Thank you once again, Lord, for giving us opportunity to study your word. I pray, Lord, that you will guide me. Let the Holy Spirit speak to each every one of us. Give us, Lord, a receptive heart to understand your word. I pray, Lord, that in this message, that your name be lifted up. It will become an encouragement to us, because we know at this time of our lives, sometimes we are we feel tired, we feel we are not in the mood of serving you. Lord, help us and forgive us. And I pray, Lord, that this message will challenge us and encourage us, Almighty God. And I ask, Lord, for your guidance, forgive us from all our sins. All these things I ask and pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Okay, you all may be seated. It's cold today, and become getting colder. Okay, so in this last time, I remember when I preached here, we study in 2 Kings chapter 5 about the Naaman and Elijah. The miracles of what he Naaman is a leper, and because of his belief, he believed on the God of Israel, he was healed. And that's what we discussed last time. And then now we move on the chapter 6 of 2 Kings, and we will study only until 1 to 7. It says here, "And the sons of the prophets said unto Elisha, Behold, now the place where we dwell with thee is too strait for us." So here, in this verse, the school of the prophets had grown to the point that they needed to provide new facilities. So if you remember, when the time of Gehazi, when Elisha and Naaman was healed, Naaman go back to Syria, and then Gehazi heard that Elisha didn't accept the offer of Naaman, and Gehazi go to Naaman to ask for something. And Gehazi said, there are two sons of the prophets, or a student during the time. And he said, they need assistance, they need money in order for them to continue. If you're going to look at that, only a few students in the time of Gehazi. And then after that, when Gehazi was gone, they multiply. The son of the prophets, or the student of Elisha, multiplied. We can see here that Gehazi is just a parabang napigilan niya yung paglago ng gawain ng Panginoon dahil sa kanyang motibo, But when he was gone, it was multiplied. That's why here in verse 1, it says, the sons of the prophets said unto Elisha, behold, now the place where we dwell with thee is too strait for us. It becomes small, and we cannot fit anymore. That's why we need to expand. And then it says, as they are in the process of cutting down trees to build their new home, one of the sons of the prophets loses his axe head in the Jordan River, and he becomes worried because the axe head was borrowed, and we will discuss that later. He cries out to Elisha, and the great prophet performs a miracle, and the axe head floats to the surface, and the man puts out his hand and picks it up. That's in the last verse. Now lest we be too harsh on this poor man who lost the axe head, let us remember that he is engaged in great work. He is busy. He really wants to involve in the ministry of in doing the work of God. Yet, if there is a flaw in his activity, it is found in this. He was working, but he was not watching. So there are times in our life when we are working, but we are not watching what we are doing. As a consequence, he lost the axe head and was unable to continue to work his work. He had lost his cutting edge and his effectiveness. But we may look at this story and wonder if there is anything here for the modern church that we can find here. And there is plenty here for us to learn. You see here, the axe head represents the power of the great job done. Without that axe head, he cannot perform his job like cutting trees. No man chopped down trees by swinging at them with an axe handle, only the handle. It will not work without that cutting edge. It takes the sharp cutting power of the axe head to cut through the wood and fell the tree. Now, in the church, we need to realize that without our cutting edge, that is the power of the Holy Spirit. Without the power of the Holy Spirit, we will never be able to serve the Lord properly. Nor will we be able to make a dent in this world. We need God and His power to get the job done for His glory. We need the Lord. You know, sadly, today the churches has become so tied in to its tradition and its programs that for the most part, our cutting edge has been lost. As a result, there is no power in the church, in the lives of the saints, or in anything we do. We have lost our effectiveness because there are times when we serve, when we are serving the Lord in the church, we rely on our own power. We forget already that we need the Holy Spirit. Example, you are used to it doing something like you always sing, you always preach. Sometimes you rely on yourself. You don't. I heard some preacher said, I don't need to study. The Holy Spirit will lead me when I stand up. So I think it sounds ridiculous. Because they're used to it. They rely on their power. So most of what we do in the church can be done without the agency of the power of the Holy Spirit. We are so good at what we do that we can operate in the power of the flesh, and no one notices the absence of God. However, while we may be able to operate our churches, our programs, and our lives apart from the power of God, we will never make a difference in the world apart from the power of God. We cannot do anything without God in us. We will never be able to serve the Lord in an effective manner until we perform the service in His power alone. That's why we need to rely on the power of God. Now here, in this message, it's not a long message, the title of our message today is, Have You Lost Your Effectiveness for the Lord? Have you lost your effectiveness for the Lord? You know, sometimes when we are serving the Lord and we are used to it, sometimes we just rely on ourselves. And then we don't know that we are not relying on the power of the Holy Spirit, and we become ineffective anymore. Like this story here, this young student lost his axe head, and he lost his effectiveness in doing his work. Have you ever lost your effectiveness in doing the Lord's work? You know, our effectiveness is through the power of the Holy Spirit. Sometimes we are relying on our own power. We forgot to rely on the power of the Holy Spirit. If we've lost our effectiveness for the Lord, we need to ask God to help us get it back. And there are a couple of things in this passage that teaches us that that just might help us and get back our effectiveness for the Lord. I know in our Christian life, sometimes we feel that we are not effective anymore in serving the Lord. I remember when I was in the Philippines, I was a Sunday school teacher when I was in college. I remember Sister Jalila, Sister K are my student, Sunday school student. And then during that time, I didn't feel that I'm not effective anymore. I'm just doing it. I'm not preparing. Just stand up in the, because I said it's only children. I can easily bola them. And then I realized that I'm not effective anymore. I'm just relying on my own without asking the guidance of the Holy Spirit. That's what happened here in this story, although this is about losing the axe head, but we can learn something about this story. Now first, like the young student in our text, we must admit that we have lost our effectiveness. This is the first thing that we need to do. Number one, we must admit that we have lost our effectiveness. If we in verse 5, it says here, let's start with verse 2. Let us go, we pray thee, unto Jordan, and take thence every man a beam, and let us make us a place there where we may dwell. And he answered, go ye. They asked Elisha permission to do the work of the Lord, and then Elisha granted, said, you can go. And one of the students said, be content, I pray thee, and go with thy servants. And he answered, I will go. So this is a good example of a leader in every thing, every service or every ministry of the church, he really involved. And so he went with them, and when they came to Jordan, they cut down wood. But as one was felling a beam, the axe head fell into the water, and he cried and said, alas, master, for it was borrowed. So here in verse number 5, this man lost his axe head, and he is not effective anymore in doing the work of cutting trees. Now there are times in our Christian life when we are serving the Lord and we feel that we lost our effectiveness, but sometimes we don't admit that we are not relying on the power of the Holy Spirit. Here we need to understand, we need to admit that we have lost our effectiveness in order for us to serve God again in effective manner. Now the first step the young student had to take was to admit that he no longer had his cutting edge, for it had slipped on his axe handle, flew in the Jordan River, and sank to the bottom of the flowing current. He was busy doing important work for God, but suddenly he was no longer effective at it. Sometimes we are unaware, even though we are working for the Lord, we are serving the Lord, but we are not effective anymore. Remember that to admit that we have a problem is the first step, and often the most difficult step. It is really difficult that you will accept yourself that why I'm not effective anymore in serving the Lord, because of our pride. We have pride. We can say that, no, I can do this, even though sometimes we don't even pray on what we are doing for the Lord. Now, the young student could have reacted in other ways instead of admitting that he had a problem. He could have been happy that he lost his axe head, and he could have used this as an excuse to stop working for God altogether, so he can use that. Now, he could have found him a nice, cool shade of tree and then take an ease and relax. drink some cold water or anything and just watch his fellow students to do all the work. He can do that. Now, on the other hand, he could have refused to admit that he lost his axe head. He can do that. But and he could have said, I have no problem. I don't have any problem. We can do that if we will not admit that we are not effective anymore. Maybe some our fellow brethren watching us and then try to ask us, brother, do you have any problem? Then we have hard time to admit that we have a problem. I said, no, I'm okay. I know I'm doing the work of God, but we at the back of our mind or deep inside, we know that we are not effective anymore in serving the Lord. And have you ever considered the fact that all our abilities, resources, and talents are borrowed? All of these things that we have is borrowed from the Holy Spirit. Remember, the Bible says when we accepted the Lord Jesus, when we believe and repent of our sin, become the sons of God, the Holy Spirit will give us gifts, and He will empower us to do something for the church in order to be used. But sometimes we forget that our abilities and our talents are borrowed, and it came from the Lord, and we think that it came from us. Now, if we have lost our effectiveness for the Lord in doing His work, the first thing we should do is to admit that we have a problem. This is a hard thing to do because it's difficult to say to ourselves that we are not effective anymore. Maybe you will say, oh, there are people who are watching me. If I will do this, maybe they will not believe me anymore. You know, God knows what our hearts, and He knows what we are doing. And we know also to ourselves that we are not effective anymore. We can see that. Sometimes when we go to our outreaches, we are tired, and sometimes we feel lazy. And when we go there, just say anything, and then we keep on looking the time that we need to end the service. It really happens to us. But if we will not accept that we are not effective anymore, so it will just continue. We think that we are doing the work of God. God is working in us. No. We need to remember, and we need to put in our mind that we need the power of the Holy Spirit. We don't need to rely on ourselves. So that's the first thing that this young man do. The sons of the prophets. He admitted that he lost his effectiveness. And then second, like this young student, number two, we need to determine the exact spot where we lost our effectiveness. Where we lost our effectiveness. In verse 6, it says here, and the man of God said, where fell it? Elisha asked, where did you lost that axe? And he showed him the place. And he cut down a stick and cast it in thither, and the iron did swim. So, have you ever had the problem in misplacing things? Sometimes when especially when you are getting older, sometimes you misplace things. Even me, in my age, I'm 30 years old, still, ano po ako, magpo-44 na. Now, I really forget where did I put things, where I place it. And my wife said, oh, why, even the key of my motor, that's why I always put in the door. And if I didn't put that there, I really forget where did I put. So there is a problem in misplacing things. Now, when we hear someone losing his or her things, one of the first things we ask them is, do you remember where you were when you last had them? So that's the question, where did you lost it? Elisha asked basically the same question here, where did it fall? So Elisha asked this student, where did you lost it? You know, from personal experience, a really good way to find something is to try to remember where you had it last. This young student didn't plan to lose his cutting edge or his effectiveness. It just happened. Somewhere along the road, we just have that tendency to lose our contribution to the building up of God's kingdom. And like that young student in our text here, we don't plan for this to happen. We don't. I don't know if you plan to lose your effectiveness for the Lord. You plan to backslide. I go to church, but I will not involve. We didn't plan that. It just happened. It just happened to us. As a matter of fact, something similar happened to Apostle Peter in the New Testament. When Peter said to the Lord Jesus Christ, he said, though everyone else at times stop serving you, Lord, I will not go, I will serve you. And then one day, even the faithful Peter denied the Lord Jesus Christ three times. When the cock crowed, he was reminded that we cannot rely on our power, because Peter said, I can rely on myself. But no, the Lord Jesus Christ reminded him that you cannot rely on your own power. You need to rely on the Lord. So, if we ever get to the point where we lost our effectiveness in doing God's work, we need to remember that our effectiveness was left where we had it last. Where did we lose our effectiveness? Maybe we need to ask some other question too, like, why did we lose our effectiveness with the Lord? Was it because we don't attend the Sunday school anymore or any services, thinking that the services was not important? Was it because we stopped attending church worship services on a regular basis? Was it because we became angry with someone or even jealous of someone? So there are plenty of things that we need to look where we lose our effectiveness because of these things that happened in our life. Have we lost our effectiveness because we stopped praying or reading God's word on a regular basis? I don't know if we can, you alone only can answer that. If we are still praying, we are blessed because we have a prayer meeting, our prayer vigil every Saturday. I hope we keep on praying, but sometimes we forget that it is our time. We thank Teacher Maribel, keep on reminding us to pray. Or even reading God's word in regular basis. Are we still reading the word of God? Maybe we can look back to that. Maybe I didn't read anymore. I never study anymore. I didn't pray anymore. Have we lost our effectiveness for the Lord because we've failed to witness to someone in His name? We don't even share the gospel to other people. Did we lose our effectiveness because some personal sin entangled our life? Sometimes there are sin that we don't want to ask God or keep on doing it, and we think that it's okay. No, if we will do that, we will not become effective anymore in serving the Lord. We need to go back to the Lord. Now, if we have the courage to take a deep and serious look at our personal spiritual life, we can discover where and why we lost our effectiveness of service to the Lord. So we need to sit down and think where I lost my effectiveness. Maybe we don't even pray, we don't even read the Bible, we don't share the gospel. And I think one of the hardest thing for any of us to do is to admit that we are not effective anymore. We want everyone to think that we are on the top of the heap, that we need nothing, and that we are in control. We want to show people that we are okay. We want to show people that we have no problem, even though deep inside in us, we are not effective anymore in doing the work of the Lord. Like here in verse number 5, this man, this young student, he accepted, he said that I lost the axe head. Where are the honest hearts that will cry out that say, I just don't have the fire I used to have. I have not as close to the Lord as I used to be. I need the power of God operating through me to get the job done. Sometimes it's really hard to accept that. That we think that we are okay, That we think that we don't, we pray and then we read the Bible and then we don't know that, we didn't realize that we are not effective anymore. What we need are honest hearts that will tell the truth about our condition. That's why we need to check our condition, our spiritual life. We just need to come clean and tell the Lord that the truth about where we are. He already knows, but He wants us to know as well. We need to learn, to relearn the path of the altar. We need to surrender to God. That's why we keep on hearing the Word of God that without God, the Bible says, without me, you can do nothing. Without the Lord, we can do nothing out of God. We cannot rely on our own power. We need His and His power in our midst. But there is a price to pay. Part of that price is confessing our lack of power. We need to humble. The Bible says, humble yourselves in the mighty hand of God. We need to humble to the Lord that we cannot do anything without Him. The lesson for the church is clear. When we are working for the Lord as we should, we are operating with a borrowed power. We are, the Lord Jesus Christ gave us the Holy Spirit in order to work for the Lord. Sometimes we forget that our ability and our talent are borrowed. If we are going to serve the Lord and see eternal results from our service, we must accept the fact that we are unable to do the work within ourselves. This is the secret to serve the Lord, that we need to realize that the Holy Spirit, we need the Holy Spirit in order to work with us. That's why the Bible says that we need to yield to the Holy Spirit in order to be used by Him in His vineyard. When the youngest student lost his axe or lost his effectiveness in doing the work, he first had the courage to admit the fact that he didn't have his cutting edge anymore. He didn't afraid to ask that he lost his axe head, or he has that courage to tell Elisha, I'm not effective anymore. How can you help me? So if we can do that, if we feel that we are not, if we think that we are not effective anymore, and we know, and I know, I believe that you know that I'm not effective anymore in doing the work of the Lord. That's why we need to come to the Lord and ask. We can ask our guidance for our pastor, ask advice to him, and go to the Word of God. Now, then he determined the exact place where he lost it. So he determined where did he lost his effectiveness. That's why he pointed out. And then we need to realize, where did I lost my effectiveness? Maybe we are not praying anymore. We are not reading anymore the Word of God. We are not really serious in doing the work of God. Or it seems that it is just, we are used to it. Kasi pag yung nasanay ka na, parang baliwala na lang. No? Just like when you are teaching. I remember this pandemic is really difficult for us teachers to have an online class, because you need to prepare many things. We are not used to it. That's why it's really difficult to teach. But like when you are in front of the class, like me, I know what I'm teaching for a long time. That's why I prepare only simple plan to teach, and then I can execute it because I was used to it. And then I don't study anymore. I'm relying on my own. You know, in serving the Lord, we cannot do that. We need to always rely on the Lord to, and the power of the Holy Spirit. Because if we don't rely on the power of the Holy Spirit, time will come. We know that we are not effective anymore. We think that we are still effective, but we are not effective in doing the work of the Lord. So that's the number two. Number three, what he did in order to go back his effectiveness. Number three, he did his part in recovering his axe of effectiveness. In verse 6, it says here, verse 6b, and he showed him the place, and he cut down a stick and cast it in thither, and the iron did swim. So he did his part in recovering the axe. And in verse 7, therefore said he, said Elisha, take it up to thee. And he put out his hand and took it. You know, Elisha was not a magician. He was a chosen prophet of the Almighty God. The power of Elisha had to perform miracles wasn't his own power. It was the power from God. Therefore, the miracle of the part of Elisha not only shows that Elisha was concerned about this young student problem, but more importantly, this miracle shows us that God was deeply concerned. This miracle clearly illustrates some basic truths about God. It says that first, God is deeply concerned with us as individual. Maybe sometimes we are thinking that, who am I? Maybe God doesn't care. You know, God really cares for us. The reason why God sent His Son to die on the cross because of us. I don't know if you remember when even one person was lost, the Lord, God will still save that person. We are important in the sight of God. Sometimes we think that we are forgotten or God didn't mind us. Remember, God is deeply concerned with us as individual. There were an entire company of young prophet students cutting down trees that day, yet God took the time to help the one who had a problem. And then we see that in Jesus' teaching about the lost sheep, the lost coin, and the parable of the lost son that was mentioned here in the Bible, you and I are very valuable to God. God, maybe you are thinking you are not valuable anymore. You know, God, like this, the teaching of the lost sheep, remember? The lost sheep, only he left the 99 and find the one, the lost coin, even though that person had that many coins, and then he still find a way to find that coin. And also the parable of the lost son, we know that we are so valuable to God that he said he created us in his own image. You know, another truth is that with God, there are no problems too small to bring to God's attention. Maybe you are thinking that our problem is small, we just don't mind it, but you know, big problems start from small problem. So that's why we need to ask God. And in 2 Peter, in 1 Peter 5 says, casting all your care upon him, for he careth for you. God really cares for us. Even though we don't even think that sometimes it seems that God is far from us, God is not, God left us, because we experiencing these things, we are experiencing these difficulties during this time. Maybe we are asking, Lord, where are you when I needed you most? No, God is always there. Remember that God, there are no problem too small to bring to God's attention. He always look at us. I remember the song that was sang a while ago. Now, do you have a problem or concern today? Have you cast the problem or concern upon God? I know all of us have cares in our life. We have problem. Did we give it to God? Like this young man, he has a problem because he is not effective anymore. And he lost his axe head. And we know that axe head was important to him. And he said it was borrowed. That's why he mentioned here in verse number 5, alas, Master, for it was borrowed. Ito expression to sa nawala. Saan na napunta yon? Kaya sabi niya, kailangan kong makita. At he accepted that he has a problem. And then, God help him. You know, a man losing an axe head may not seem like a big of a deal, but God thought it was. God not only cares about us and is concerned about our problems, but God will help us to solve our problems that in turn will return honor and glory back to God. With that, God will be honored if we will ask God to help us, because and we know that God will find a way to give back the glory to Him. God will cause the solution to float to the surface like this ox said. It just float on the water. But now let's talk about what this young man student did to get back his cutting edge or effectiveness. What this young man did in order to be effective again in doing the work of God. Here in verse 7, therefore said he, said Elisha, take it up to thee. And he put out his hand and took it. His work didn't end when he admitted that he had the problem. And it didn't end when he sought help from the prophet Elisha. It doesn't end there. Elisha had the power, a spiritual gift from God, to make that axe head flow to the top of the water and then fly straight up of the water in the air and back on that wooden handle. But he didn't do that. God can do miracles like that. It's just magic. It will just go there. But God didn't do that. Why? Why do you suppose Elisha didn't do that? Remember, because God wants us to participate with the work of God. God can do, you know, God can save us. But we need to repent of our sin. We need to believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. That's why this is the debate about we hear that about Calvinism. He said you don't need to do anything. If you are chosen, God will save you. Oh, I think it's that. I don't know. If it's really ridiculous to think about that. And then that we need to do our part. Although we don't have we cannot save ourselves, but we need to repent and believe. And the Lord Jesus, like this man, he told Elisha that he has a problem. He lost his effectiveness, and Elisha did the miracle. And then what he did is said, "Oh, go, you take it now. You do your part. You get the axe and then put it back again, and then do the work." You know, God wanted this young man to be involved in his own recovery. You know, God wants us to do that. We need to realize that we need to exert effort in serving the Lord. It's not just a magic that God will give us power and then you will become effective again. But we need to do our part. We have volition. We need to choose. We have a free will. We need to choose if we want to obey God or not. That's why God gave us that will in order to do our part. Because God is not, He didn't make us a robot that whatever God will say, you will do. It's up to us. Ayan nga, may sabi ni Soriano, may hindi kayang gawin ng Diyos. Parang, alam mo, may sayad talaga. Hindi niya daw kayang pigilin yung ating kalooban. Ewan ko, ewan na siya na ngayon. So, ganun po. But God gave us this will in order to serve Him willfully. And we need to do our part. God wanted him, this young man, to reach out his hand and recover the axe head himself. Be honest with ourselves this day. Let's take a serious look at our effectiveness in doing God's kingdom work. I know all of us here are working for the Lord. And let's look, am I really effective again? And if we realize that we are not effective anymore in serving the Lord, like this young man, he accepted that he lost his effectiveness. He lost his axe head. And then, take a serious look of our effectiveness in doing God's work, God's kingdom work. For us to stop trying to do the work of the Lord, to just step back, place it all in His hands, and trust Him completely is difficult. However, it is the only solution. The only solution to go back is to accept and then do something for it. That God will really help us to do it. One of the primary steps in recovering the cutting edge of the power of the church is a return to God. We need to go back to God. You know, the churches today, like in the Philippines, they just relying on their own power. They're relying on their programs. They said, without this, we cannot invite people. You know, they are thinking that there is no power in the Word of God. They need things to do in order to attract world so that they can go to church. No, the Word of God is powerful. The Bible says, the Word of God is quick and powerful and sharper than to any edged sword. So, the Word of God has a power to save. And we need that in order to be effective. This is a great text in the Bible, but the verse that we have read, but do you know that this young student could have avoided all of his problem if he had only checked his axe head occasionally? So this is the secret. We need to check if we are still effective in doing the work of God. We can check it, and we know what we are doing for the Lord. Am I really, am I still effective for the Lord? You know, if this young man, young student, if keeps on checking when he's cutting the trees, and he checked that his axe is already loose, he need to adjust and to tighten up again. But he was, he ignored it. He don't realize that it will happen, that the axe will lose. That's why if he really, what do you call that? I remember the quotation, the ounce of prevention is better than a pound of cure. We need to check our spiritual life, even in our car, our motorcycle. We keep on checking that in order to work properly. Same in our spiritual life, we need to check. We too need to check our spiritual tools on a regular basis. When is the last time we did this? When was the last time we check ourselves? When we check out our spiritual inventory on a regular basis, we can make minor adjustment and keep on serving the Lord. We don't need to make the problem big. If we see a problem, we need to come to the Lord, Lord, help me. Because if we will was involved in that problem, sometimes it's really difficult to go out. I remember when I started to smoke, I just tried first. And a small thing, I said, I can control this. But time comes, I cannot control it anymore. I can use one pack of cigarette per day. And then I said, I cannot stop it anymore. But I come to the Lord, Lord, help me. I cannot do it by my own. And that's the time I stop it. You know, if I stop it when I'm just tasting it, maybe I will not go in that far. So the same way in our spiritual life. When we think that we are not praying anymore, we are not reading the Bible anymore, we give more time on our gadget, our looking for Facebook and playing games, maybe it's time for us again, Lord, I know this is not, I didn't say that's bad, that we need to balance. We need to understand that what is more important for us a Christian life. We need to check if our effectiveness is really, if we have a problem in serving the Lord. Check out our iron axe head of spiritual service and make sure everything is okay in our personal relationship with the Lord. Make sure you're not swinging away with just wooden stick without the axe head. Maybe we are serving the Lord, but we are not effective anymore. Make any needed repairs to go back to work. We need to have an inventory on what we are doing for God. Like in verse 7 here, therefore he said, take it up to thee and put up in his hand. And he took it. And the last thing this young man did was to reach down and take the axe head in his hand. He committed to receiving by faith that which the Lord had done. So God did a miracle, and God wants us to do our part. God can do miracle for us. But if we are not willing to accept that miracle, God will not force that miracle to happen in our life. If we are really willing to become effective again with God, God will not enforce us, or God will not do a miracle for us to become effective without our willingness to be used by God again. Now, this may be the end of the story as far as the biblical record is concerned, but we can be sure of what happened next. This young man firmly reattached the axe head to the handle and went back to work chopping down trees, and he had recovered the cutting edge and was able to do what needed to be done. You know, God has a power available for those who will pay the price for it and who will reach out and take it by faith. You know, this message is really, for me personally, when I study this, it really helps me that I know there are times in my life that, Lord, I think I'm not effective anymore. Lord, please help me. I know I need your power. I need the power of the Holy Spirit. We need God in our life. We cannot do this without the power of God. And sometimes we are used to that ministry that we think that we can do that without asking God for help. But the Bible says, without God, we can do nothing. Without God, we can do nothing. That's why we need to understand. And if you check every time your relationship with God, your spiritual status, that's good, because God will help us, will give us grace to obey His will if we are really willing to obey God in our life. We need to rely on the power of the Holy Spirit. And we know that without the power of the Holy Spirit, we cannot do anything. Every time what we are doing for God, let's give the glory to God. The Bible says, whether therefore you eat or drink or whatsoever you do, do it for the glory of God. And it is only the thing that we can say that God is using us. If we give the glory back to Him, we don't rely on ourselves. And then a reminder, again, like what this young man did, he asked for help. He said that he has a problem. He admitted that he had a problem, and he did something to solve the problem, because God will help us whatever problem we had if we humble ourselves. Lord, I know I have a problem. Please help me. I know I cannot do this. Lord, help me. I know God will listen to our prayer if we really ask Him to guide us. And then we need to do our part to come back to the Lord. So that's what the message that I want you to share here in this story in 2 Kings chapter 6, verse 1 to 7. I hope that this will remind us, or if we are really serving the Lord, really praise the Lord. Glory to God for that. But I know time comes in our life that we feel that we are ineffective. We don't want to work for the Lord anymore. Maybe it's a time to go back to God, to ask the Lord for help, and to ask the power of the Holy Spirit in our life. Thank you, and let's pray. Our Father in heaven, Lord, thank you so much for this.